Welcome my dear student friends, how are you all? I hope you are all doing fine and well. So in today's class we will be learning about the FCFS scheduling algorithm. In the previous videos I have already uploaded the FCFS scheduling algorithm, priority scheduling algorithm, round robin scheduling algorithm and also the HGF scheduling algorithm. So in the previous videos I have already covered all those algorithms the problem was that the sound quality was not good because I didn't had the mic at that particular time, so sound quality was not good. So I am again making the videos on the same topics, and again I will be going to upload it in the YouTube on those scheduling algorithms. So be tuned. And if you want to see my previous videos on those scheduling algorithms, you can get it in the YouTube, and the recent videos also shortly I am going to upload. Okay, fine. So my name is Surya Bahadur and I welcome you all to my channel Educate Youth. So let's start the today's class in FCFS scheduling algorithm, right? So let's start the today's class. So today's topic is about the scheduling algorithm. So we are going to cover the FCFS scheduling algorithm, your SJF scheduling algorithm, round robin scheduling algorithm and priority scheduling algorithm. So four important scheduling algorithm we are going to cover in a phase wise manner. So in today's class I will be covering the FCFS scheduling algorithm. So all the scheduling algorithm comes with your operating system. It is embedded with your operating system that you are purchasing, right? If you are having the Windows operating system, your scheduling algorithm comes along with your operating system, right? So we'll be going for discussing the FCFS scheduling algorithm, right? So before moving for FCFS scheduling algorithm, I want to discuss some important terms. Okay, so what do you mean by preemptive? I'll say that one scheduling algorithm is a preemptive scheduling algorithm. What does it mean? Okay, so for example, one process enters into the processor, right? So when it enters into the processor, it starts execution in the processor, and some high priority process also wants to enter into the processor, then the process which is executing right now is a low priority process. So what the operating system will do is that the operating system will tell the low priority process to come out, then the low priority process will be coming out without completing its full execution time, right? Then the high priority process will be capturing the processor for execution, right? So this is called the preemptive, right? The low priority process has come out from the processor, that means it has preempted out from the processor without completing its full execution. Understood? That is preemptive. What is non-preemptive? Non-preemptive. Non-preemptive process. A process is a non-preemptive process. That means a scheduling algorithm is a non-preemptive scheduling algorithm. This is my sentence, right? What does it mean? What do you mean by non-preemptive? Non-preemptive means, see, if a process captures the processor and the process will be executing in that processor, and if any other process wants to capture that processor, the processor which is executing right now will not be listening anyone. So it will start, continue its execution, and after completing only it will come out. That means that particular process is a non-preemptive process, right? That means it will come out only after completing its execution. So that is the case of non-preemptive. Okay, whichever process will be holding the processor, that process will be completing its execution, then only it will be exiting out. That is the non-preemptive. Next, scheduler. What do you mean by scheduler? See, scheduler is a system software which is responsible for scheduling your job or the process in the processor. okay? The processes, are in the RAM, in the random access memory or their primary memory, and they have to be scheduled properly and sent to the processor for execution, right? So who is all doing that? Scheduler. Scheduler is also a system software which comes along with your operating system only. It is embedded with your operating system only. Okay. So this scheduler is responsible for scheduling your processes accordingly in a proper manner and sending it to the processor for execution. Right? Scheduler can be of two types. Okay. Mainly it can be of two types. One is short-term scheduler, and another one is long-term scheduler. So, what is short-term scheduler? What is long-term scheduler? Short-term scheduler is a scheduler who is responsible for scheduling your job or processes from your primary memory to the processor. This is the covering distance. That is a short-term scheduler. The scheduler responsible for making the processes to be scheduled from your primary memory to the processor. That distance is the short-term scheduler. Short-term scheduler will be doing that job, that activity, right? What is long-term scheduler? Long-term scheduler is a scheduler who is responsible for scheduling your job and processes from your secondary storage device. That's a very distance, right? From secondary storage device and bringing it into the primary memory. That is the long-term scheduler. Understood? These are the three terms that you need to understand before moving to learn about the FCFS scheduling algorithm. Okay? So, FCFS scheduling algorithm is a non-preemptive scheduling algorithm, right? It is a non-preemptive scheduling algorithm. Understood? So, what is non-preemptive scheduling algorithm? Understood? So, when a process will be holding the processor, then the processor, that means the process will not be coming out from the processor until it completes its execution. Samajh mein aa raha hai? Non-preemptive ka matlab kya hai? वो प्रोसेस जब प्रोसेसर में चला जाता है एग्जीक्यूट करने के लिए, तो वो प्रोसेस प्रोसेसर में फुल एग्जीक्यूट हो जाता है. मतलब वो फुल कैप्चर कर लेता है, होल्ड कर लेता है प्रोसेसर को, और फुल्ली एग्जीक्यूट हो जाता है. ठीक है? और अगर कोई हाई प्रायोरिटी प्रोसेस आ रहा है और वो प्रोसेसर का डिमांड है उसका, और वो प्रोसेसर चाह रहा है एग्जीक्यूट करने के लिए, तो हाई प्रायोरिटी प्रोसेस is not able to acquire the processor because already one process is executing, and that process will be executing until it completes its execution. That is the non-preemptive, right? FCFS scheduling algorithm is a non-preemptive scheduling algorithm. Understood? So let us move to discuss the working of the FCFS scheduling algorithm. Okay, so FCFS scheduling algorithm works in a FIFO rule, right? All the processes will be coming to the RAM or the primary memory, and they will be arranged in the FIFO rule. That means first in, first out. That means whichever process has come first, that will be sent to the processor for execution, right? And in the FCFS scheduling algorithm, all the processes has to be get ready for acquiring the processor. That means all the processes are already near to the processor for execution, right? So for example, our process P1 has arrived first, process P2 has arrived second, and P3 has arrived third. In the same time, they are ready for execution, right? They have already arrived. Now, so this is the queue, and process P1 will be sent for execution first, execution completed, then process P2, execution completed, then process P3, execution completed. That means it follows the non-preemptive rule. That means once enters into the processor, it will complete its execution, then only it will come out from the processor, right? So follow the FCFS rule. So which process has come first? Your process P1. So process, so you can see in the Gantt chart, okay, in the Gantt chart, so process P1 has entered and acquiring the processor, right? So process P1 entered at the zero time, right? So it start execution. So process P1 start execution and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, what is the total burst time for the process P1? Burst time means execute time. So what is the total execution time for the process P1? 24 milliseconds or 24 units of time. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, up to 24. At time 24, the process P1 completed its execution. As FCFS is a non-preemptive scheduling algorithm, it acquires the processor and complete its execution, then only it will come out from the processor. Okay. So it is starting at 0, completing at 24, because it is taking 24 milliseconds to complete its full execution. Understood? Okay. So P1 has completed full execution at 24. Then whose turn? P2. Okay. So P2 acquires the processor. Right? P1 is printed out. Right? After completing its execution. So at 24 time, P2 acquires the processor. Right? So how much time it is taking to complete the execution? It is taking 3 units of time or 3 milliseconds of time. Right? So it is starting at 24, 25, 26, 27. At 27, P2 completes its execution. Right? So next, whose turn? Next process P3. So P3 starts at what time? At the 27 time the P3 starts its execution. So how much time it is taking for execution? Full execution? 3 milliseconds of time. Okay, so 28, 29, 30. So at 30 millisecond, here all processes will be completing its execution, right? So right now, what is the waiting time? So process waiting. So what is the waiting time for the individual processes? So we are having 3 processes, P1, P2 and P3, right? So what is the waiting time for the process P1? Process P1 has arrived first at the 0 time. So P1 is not waiting for the processor. So the waiting time for the process P1 is 0. What is the waiting time for the process P2? Process P2 has waited until P1 has completed its execution. So it has waited up to the 24 milliseconds of time. So what is the waiting time for process P2? It is 24, right? Right now. So what is the waiting time for the process P3? P3 has waited up to the 27 units of time, because after waiting for 27 units, P1 and P2 completed at 27, then P3 gets the processor. So it has waited up to 27 units of time, right? So P3 27, right? It has waited. So what is the average waiting time? Zero plus 24 plus 27 divided by total 3 processes. So what is the average waiting time for the all the process to complete? 17 units of time is the average waiting time for this particular 3 process to complete the full execution. Okay. So this is how the FCFS scheduling algorithm actually works, and it is a non-preemptive scheduling algorithm, and it is a very beneficial scheduling algorithm. Okay. But some disadvantages are also there in this particular scheduling algorithm. In, for example, if you are going for time sharing system, so this FCFS scheduling algorithm will be creating the problem. So in the time sharing system, there will be a situation of starvation. Okay, starvation. Starvation means what? For example, I am very hungry. Okay, I am very hungry. So I want the food. Okay, so since 8 hours I haven't taken the food, I am feeling very hungry. So I can make a sentence: I am starving for the food. Understood? I am starving for the food. Same situation happens. Okay? Same situation happens. That means if in case of time sharing system, if they are following the FCFS scheduling algorithm, in that situation starvation may occur if they are following the FCFS scheduling algorithm. How? So for example, if a process is having a long period of execution time, like in this case we have seen P1 is taking 24 milliseconds of time for its full execution, right? So in large systems, lot of processes will be there. So I have taken a very simple example to make you understand. Okay, so lot of number of processes will be there. They will be trying to get the processor for execution, right? So in that situation, if a single process is having a very long period of time to complete its execution, and according to FCFS is a non-preemptive, then in that situation the process will be holding the processor for a long period of time. For example, P1 is having 1000 milliseconds of time to complete its execution. So it will enter into the processor. As that process is a non-preemptive, it cannot come out until it completes its execution. So other processes which is having the short time period of execution, those processes will be waiting to complete the process P1 to complete its execution. So when that waiting situation comes, that means those processes who are waiting, they are starving for the processor. That is the starvation situation. Those processes, low execution time processes, will be starving for the processor, because the process which is having long execution time will be holding that processor and it is not releasing until it completes its execution. So here the starvation situation happens. Understanding? So that is the one of the most disadvantage of the FCFS scheduling algorithm. So if you are going for time sharing systems, right? So I hope you understood the FCFS scheduling algorithm. So in the next topic, I will be going for discussing the SJF scheduling algorithm, then priority scheduling algorithm, then round robin scheduling algorithm. So I hope you understood the FCFS scheduling algorithm. So we'll meet in the next class.